In this video, I will tell you 5 daily routines of a PhD student to get a PhD in time. And we are starting right after this short break. Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Tahir, and if this is your first time, please hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell to get notified whenever I post a new video on this channel every Tuesday and Friday. When students start a PhD degree, they feel a freedom. Freedom from stressful professional life, or if they are coming from a coursework program, they feel free. And this is the time when they start developing some bad habits. For example, using social media a lot, watching movies, or hanging out with friends for a long period of time. The time lost in the beginning of their PhD will never be recovered and they will regret it. So what they should be doing instead? In this video, we are going to discuss 5 daily routines or activities which they should be doing on a daily basis. I'm not saying that they should only be doing these 5 things. But these 5 things must be part of most of their days. And these 5 activities altogether should not consume more than 40 to 60% of their day. So keep this bigger picture in your mind. So now let's talk about what are the activities. So the first thing is, look at your notes and to-do list. I have discussed this in many other videos that when you start a PhD, you must start taking notes, whether on your own diary or any web-based diary or any application, any note-taking app. So you decide a note-taking app or get a diary and stick to it. I have also developed a diary for PhD students, which is called Digit Idea Diary 1, which is available on Amazon if you want, but this is not a sales pitch for that diary. You can use your own diary. I just have put some columns, and if you fill those columns and follow those prompts, your PhD will be under control. But using any diary or note-taking app is sufficient. So the first activity is look at your notes and your to-do list. Now, to-do list I am not talking about here because you understand how to use it, but what to look at your notes and what you should keep in your notes in the first place. So the things you should be keeping in the notes of your diary is, for example, if any idea clicks into your mind, you just put that idea in your notes. If you are reading a paper and you think that you might be doing an experiment, you put that experiment idea into your diary. So a note can take anything which is related to your PhD. So every morning, you first have a look at your notes. Because what happens, sometime we got a very important idea. We put on our diary, but then we forget about it. So when you have this routine of having a look at your notes, so you should be able to focus and link all those. Because this is the problem. When you start PhD, there is a chaos. Everything is looking very complex and everything is unorganized. But with the passage of time, all things will fall into places and your PhD will become organized. So this is very important that you have a look at your notes every day. Now the second activity you should be doing is reading at least 6 pages of a paper. So there are few things you should be taking into consideration, and these are my 5 tips for reading. As I mentioned in one of my other videos, that you must first of all create a bank of keywords related to your field of research. You must have a comprehensive list of keywords which relates to your field of research, because these keywords you will be using to find the literature. So find the literature by using those bank of keywords. This is your first step to select a paper, and think twice before you select this for reading, because when you are reading, you are spending time which is valuable. So don't just select every paper. See the title, read the abstract, and then select it or reject it. Now, when I say read 6 pages of a paper, so some papers are only 6 pages, most of the conference papers, but general papers are long enough. Not just read 6 pages, but also comprehend those 6 pages. Try to understand what is written in there. Now the second tip is, don't make a long list in the beginning of your career, because in the beginning you don't know what paper is important or not. Tip number 3 is that you should send the titles of these papers which you have selected to read to your supervisor, because this is the job of supervisor to tell you whether it's relevant or not. he will be a better judge. So send the titles to your supervisor or show him in the meeting. And the fourth tip is, don't print any research paper. I have seen PhD students who have piles of papers on their desks, which they never read again. They just print and never read again. This has happened to me as well. I have printed a lot of papers which I never read later on. So don't print anything. The last tip is that while you are reading, you must take notes. You highlight the important things, and you can use some app for this purpose. For example, Evernote Web Clipper. I have a separate video on Web Clipper. You can watch that video. So these are five tips. So you must read 6 pages and comprehend those 6 pages every day, at least. Now the third activity which you should be doing on a daily basis is to learn skills for data analysis, data presentation, and presentation. Presentation means presentation in seminars, which is the most useful activity for a PhD student. I have a separate video if you want to watch about data analysis. But shortly, I will tell you that when I talk about data analysis, you should be looking at the techniques which you can use, statistical or linear algebra or some other techniques which you should be using to analyze the data. When we say data presentation, then we are talking about how to draw technical scientific diagrams, which package or which library you should be using. And when we talk about presentation skills, you understand what I mean. That how to present your work to other scientists. So this is the third activity. Now the fourth activity is that you decide every day that what is my task of today? What is the important but small task which will bring me closer to my PhD? So this task could be a very small task. For example, designing an experiment, designing a questionnaire, or arranging an equipment, anything like that which is important or which your supervisor tells you. Any task, at least one important task for your PhD, you must be doing on a daily basis. Think about it, put it on your notes and do it. Now the last activity which you should be doing on a daily basis is writing. Writing is very important for scientists, and you cannot learn writing just by attending a writing class. Although that will help, but you become a good writer by writing. So therefore, every day you must write at least 200 words in the beginning. And as you become a little bit experienced, you should increase these words. So from 200 to 300 to 400. And now I would like to give you 3 quick tips about writing. But one important thing to note here is that these reading and writing tips are not just enough for you to understand writing or reading. People have made videos of hours on writing and reading, because these topics deserve a lot of attention. But these 3 tips will still help you to understand the bigger picture. So the first tip is that avoid bad writing. Now, what is bad writing? The bad writing is which reader cannot understand. So after you write something, give it to your friend or some colleague or even to your supervisor, and ask for a honest feedback, and try to accept the criticism in the beginning of your PhD. This is very important. When you are asking for honest feedback, then you have the ability to accept the honest feedback. So avoid bad writing. For example, if you are emphasizing on a particular thing, whether they understood that part of the writing or not. So these kind of things, reader must understand what you are trying to say. So this is one thing from reader's perspective. The second tip from your side is that you must be writing with clarity. Clarity is very important in writing. Don't use fancy words if you don't know how to use them. Just try to write clear, simple, plain English. And the third important tip, which is a little bit hard in the beginning, but I would like to give you here because it's very important, that you must understand how to provide evidence to something, how to provide the evidence to your scientific claim. And in order to provide the evidence, you need to have some scientific vocabulary. You must understand some scientific terminology in order to support your claim. And this vocabulary is hard to achieve. And remember one thing, scientific writing is a foreign language even for native English speakers, if we are talking about English here. So this is not a foreign language just for you. If you are from a non-English speaking background like myself, this is a foreign language for native people as well. Because the scientific vocabulary is totally different than the normal everyday English. So therefore, try to increase your vocabulary, and this vocabulary will again be increased by reading a lot. When you read a lot of journal papers, your vocabulary, your scientific vocabulary will definitely increase, and this will help you in writing. So try to write every day, and better if you try to start writing your thesis very early in your career. This I have mentioned in other videos. So these are some of the activities which you can do on a daily basis to get a PhD in time. So I hope you like this video. If so, please give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.